So this is the equation we got after the integration. So B is equal to mu naught ni a square by 2r cube into 2l. So I am multiplying with 2 pi and dividing with 2 pi this equation. So multiply and divide with 2 pi. So B is equal to mu naught ni a square 2l into 2 pi by 2 into 2 pi r cube. So if you see this equation, we can write this one as n I a square r n I pi a square into 2 into 2l by 4 pi r cube into mu naught. If you see this one, n I into pi a square into 2 into 2l into mu naught by 4 pi r cube. So in this whole equation, n into pi a square into 2l, n into pi a square into 2l into I into 2 into mu naught by 4 pi r cube. What is this n into 2l? Number of turns per unit length into length is nothing but the number of turns in the length. N, this is A, means area of the circle. This is I. N I A, nothing but the magnetic moment. So N into 2L is equal to capital N. Pi A square is equal to area. Therefore, N into 2L into pi a square into I is equal to n I a, nothing but m, where m is equal to magnetic moment. So now I am substituting this magnetic moment in this expression. So finally, magnetic moment or magnetic field due to a solenoid will become mu naught by 4 pi into 2m by r cube, where m is equal to n I a, where n is equal to n into 2l, I is equal to I into a is equal to pi a square. This aperture is nothing but the radius of the circular element. So we got that a bar magnet is acting as a solenoid. So the expression of the magnetic field due to a bar magnet is equal to the expression of the magnetic field due to a solenoid with respect to its single turn. So such like this, we can understand and we can equalize or we can equate these two phenomena with two different devices. So we can prove that a bar magnet is acting as an equivalent solenoid with its single turn. Now we are discussing about the dipole, which is in a uniform magnetic field. Magnet itself is a dipole. Best example of the magnetic dipole is a magnet, bar magnet. But when a dipole which is placed in a magnetic field, it experiences a torque because of the balancing of the force of attraction and force of repulsion on the either ends. So the torque experienced by this dipole when it is placed in the magnetic field is written as M cross B. Torque experienced by the dipole in uniform magnetic field. Is tau is equal to m cross b. This was already proved. We know this standard equation. So we can write this one is tau is equal to mb sin theta. In other words, it is minus mb sin theta also. So what is this tau? I alpha. In rotational dynamics, where tau we can be written as I alpha, where alpha is equal to d omega by dt, therefore it is d by dt of d theta by dt. Therefore it can be written as d square theta by dt square. So tau is equal to, we can write I into d square theta by dt square, where minus indicates the direction of magnetic field and magnetic momentum. So I into d square theta by dt square is equal to mb sin theta. D square theta by dt square is equal to mb by I sin theta. Minus. So we can write this one as d square x by dt square is equal to minus omega square x. In simple harmonic motion, we used to get this equation. So here in place of x, we have theta. So similarly, d square theta by dt square is equal to minus omega square theta. Here it is sin theta, but we are writing as theta because for small angle sin theta will become theta. So for small angles sin theta is equal to theta. So sin theta is approximately equal to theta. We can write like this. So if you compare both the equation, this equation and this equation, omega square is equal to mb by I, where omega is equal to square root of mb by I. So the time period t is equal to (2π/ω), therefore it is 2π by omega means root of mb by I. That is equal to 2π to root of I by mb. So this is the time period of this dipole which is placed in the uniform magnetic field. So we got time period t is equal to 2π into square root of I by mb. Now I want to find out the magnetic field due to this dipole which is placed in the uniform magnetic field. So squaring on both sides, so t square is equal to 4π² into I by mb. So this b will go there. Therefore b is equal to 4π² by t square into I by m. So the magnetic field is inversely proportional to the magnetic momentum. That's why we wrote minus symbol there, because they both are inversely proportional. One decreases, another increases. So such like this, if you want to find out the energy of this dipole which is placed in the uniform magnetic field, therefore energy is potential energy. So the expression is u is equal to integral tau of theta d theta. What is this tau? Mb sin theta d theta. Sin theta d theta is minus cos theta. So minus into minus will become plus. So therefore it is mb cos theta. Therefore it is my m dot b. So the energy will become m dot b. If the magnetic field aligns perpendicular to the field lines, so the compass needle aligns perpendicular, then so u is equal to 0 when theta is equal to 90, u is equal to minimum when theta is equal to 0 degrees, u is equal to maximum when theta is equal to 180 degrees. Because cos 180 is minus 1, you will get the maximum answer. So it is minus m dot b minus m dot b is equal to u. So such like this, we can prove the dipole in a uniform magnetic field. Now we will discuss a numerical which is based on this concept. So this is the numerical which is based on the concept of the torque experienced by the dipole in a uniform magnetic field. So the content is, the magnetic field has magnetic moment 6.7 into 10 to the power of minus 2 am square and magnetic moment of inertia I is equal to 7.5 into 10 to the power of minus 6 kg meter square. It performs 10 complete oscillations in 6.70 seconds. What is the magnitude of the magnetic field? So magnetic moment M is equal to 6.7 into 10 to the power of minus 2 am square. Moment of inertia I is equal to 7.5 into 10 to the power of minus 6 kg meter square. It performs 10 complete oscillations in 6.070 seconds. Therefore, time period is equal to time taken by number of oscillations. So the time taken is 6.70, number of oscillations is 10, therefore it is 0.67 seconds. Now we should find out the magnetic field. B is equal to 4 pi square by t square into I by m, 4 into 3.14 whole square into what is I, 7.5 into 10 power minus 6 whole divided by t square, 0.67 whole square into m, 6.7 into 10 to the power of minus 2. So if you simplify all these values, we will get 0.01 Tesla. So this is the magnetic field which was obtained with the given dimensions of the momentum and moment of inertia. So now we are discussing about the electrostatic analog, means the comparisons and the similarities between the electric and magnetic fields. So we know that in place of E, we should write B. In place of electric dipole momentum, we should write magnetic dipole momentum. So the constant in the electric field is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, and it is replaced by mu naught by 4 pi. In such case, electric field on axial line and electric field on equatorial line. So, on axial line, it is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into 2 pi by r cube. On equatorial line, it is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into p by r cube. So here 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught is replaced with mu naught by 4 pi, P replaced by M, then magnetic field at the axial line will become mu naught by 4 pi into 2M by R cube, and magnetic field at equatorial line is mu naught by 4 pi into M by R cube. So such like that we can write these equations in such a form. So here E becomes P, P becomes M, 1 by 4 pi epsilon becomes mu naught by 4 pi. So here the P becomes M and all these are simply constants. So next, magnet momentum, dipole momentum. In electric fields, the dipole momentum will become Q into 2L. But in magnetic fields, magnetic momentum will become M. So its symbol is M. It is NIA. Now we will see a table which gives the relation between the analogy between the electric and magnetic fields.